Good morning all. Today we are going to discuss the series resonance. So let us first see what is a resonance. Resonance means in step with. The meaning of resonance is resonance means in step with. What is the meaning of in step with? We know that if you take any circuit, that circuit, let us assume I have given to the circuit R, L and C, because we are taking the series RLC circuit now. Whenever you apply the voltage, the current is produced. So we tell that the circuit is at resonance or in step with when the voltage and current are in step with each other. That means V and I are in step with. That means they are going at the same phase, or the angle between V and I is equal to 0 degrees. The angle between V and I is equal to 0 degrees. Under that condition, we tell that the circuit is under resonance condition. So if you take the series circuit, series RLC circuit, let us assume this value is L, R, L and C. So V is applied and the current is passing. So we can get the impedance Z is equal to square root of R square plus XL minus XC whole square. And the value of current, if you want to calculate, I can calculate by V by Z. This will be equal to V by square root of R square plus XL minus XC whole square. This way I can calculate. So generally in a circuit, series circuit, the inductive reactance is dominating. Let us assume this is my current. This is my value of I into R, or this is the value of VR. And that XL minus XC, let us take it as positive. It can be negative also. This is the voltage across the inductor or the capacitor, that resultant value. So voltage across that X I am writing. So the resultant of these will give your supply voltage. So this is my angle phi. So from this I can calculate this Vx is equal to I into XL minus XC. Or from this I can calculate the value of cos phi. Cos phi is this V is equal to I into Z. Cos phi will be equal to I into R divided by I into Z, or this I can write as R by Z. So at resonance condition, I want my voltage and current should be in phase. The meaning is this cos phi should be equal to 1. So what is the meaning of 1? So 1 is equal to R by Z, or I can tell at resonance condition, the value of Z should be equal to R. So when Z will be equal to R? When this element is becoming 0. That is the condition for resonance. That means we can tell that at resonance condition, the value of Z will be equal to R. This implies that XL is equal to XC, so that the difference of XL and XC will be equal to 0. So this XL I can represent as in terms of the frequency, 2 pi f into L. This is with respect to frequency. And this capacitive reactance I can write as 2 pi f into C. At resonance condition, let us take the frequency is F suffix R. R stands for the resonance condition. So using this condition, I can calculate my value of the resonant frequency, which will be equal to 1 by 2 pi into root LC. I can calculate my value of resonance is 1 by 2 pi into root LC. So let us try to analyze further. So to analyze this further using the analytical or the graphical method, so I am just taking my frequency. So we know that the Z is equal to square root of R square plus XL minus XC whole square, where the value of XL is equal to 2 pi FL and the value of XC is equal to 1 by 2 pi FC. Or otherwise we can tell that this XL is proportional to frequency and XC is inversely proportional to frequency. So let us try to draw each one of them. I am taking the reactance here. And I am taking the frequency on the y-axis. At frequency 0, the XC will become infinite and XL will be equal to 0. And as the frequency is changing, the value of XL will change linearly. This is my value of XL. So let us take the remaining. Now taking to the XC, the value of XC is inversely proportional to the frequency. If you draw the curve, you will get one hyperbola. So the value of XC will go on decreasing with respect to the frequency. At some particular point, these two will intersect with each other. So this frequency we are defining by the FR. We are going to do that. At this point, XL is equal to XC. So XL minus XC becomes 0. That means this is the point where XL is equal to XC. So if you take the point before this, here you will observe that in this range, the value of XC is greater than XL. And after this, the value of XL is greater than XC. The XL is dominating after the resonant frequency and XC is dominating before resonant frequency. Getting this? So at this point XL is equal to XC. Let us assume my value of my resistance is this one. This is my value of my resistance. So resistance value, generally I can assume it is nearly constant with respect to change in frequency. Even though there will be effect of the skin effect, generally that multiplication factor will be something like 1.1 to 1.2. So I am just neglecting the multiplication factor. So I am assuming my resistance is linear with respect to change in the frequency. Now we know the value of Z is equal to square root of R square plus XL minus XC whole square. If you take the frequency is less than the resonant frequency, you can see the value of XC is dominating XL, or we can tell this net is not equal to 0. So automatically the Z is more. So that's why we can tell that the impedance is more if less than FR. Similarly, if you take above FR, then in that case XL will be dominating XC. Again, this difference will not be equal to 0, again Z will be more. And if you take at resonance condition XL is equal to XC, Z will be equal to R. So I am just trying to draw that. So at the resonance condition, this Z will be equal to R. If you take it below or above, it will go on increasing. So this is my graph for my impedance. So you can tell that at resonance condition, the impedance is minimum. So when the impedance is minimum, so we can calculate the value of the current. Current I is equal to V by Z. So at resonance condition, so this ZR will be equal to resistance. So V by R. So this will be maximum, because ZR is minimum at resonance condition. So automatically current will be maximum. Let us try to summarize what we have observed, then we will proceed further for the further analysis. So I am just summarizing. At resonance, we got that the value of XL is equal to XC. That is the first observation. Second observation, the resonant frequency is equal to 1 by 2 pi into root LC. This is the second observation. And the third observation, we have seen that this ZR will be minimum at the resonance, so which will be equal to R. Why? The reason is XL is equal to XC. That is the reason. So now the fourth one, we have observed that the current that is passing through the circuit at resonance will be equal to V by Z resonance. V by Z resonance will be nothing but V by R. This will be maximum. So this also we have just analyzed. Then the fifth one, we have seen the power factor at resonance will be equal to unity, because the angle between the voltage and current is 0, or power factor will be cos phi will be equal to unity. So then the sixth observation, as IR is maximum, so when IR is maximum, the drop in RLC series circuit. In a series circuit, we know the power will be lost only because of the resistance, which will be equal to I square R. So at resonance condition, the current is maximum, resistance is constant, the current is maximum. So automatically we can tell that this power dissipated is maximum at resonant condition. This is one more observation. And now the seventh observation, so if you are taking the R, L and C, I have just applied some voltage and the current is passing. Let us assume under resonance condition R, L and C, the value of XL is equal to XC. We know the value of IR is maximum. When IR is maximum, the voltage drop across this R is IR into R. This also will be maximum. This will be equal to IR into XL, and this will be equal to IR into XC. So let us see how they comes. So this I am trying to draw. So if I am taking this as my current, the voltage drop across the resistance will be in phase with this. So this will become I into IR into R. Let us assume this IR is the current at resonance condition. It is maximum. So voltage drop across the inductor, we know that will lead the respective current by 90 degrees. So voltage drop VL will be equal to IR into XL. So similarly, voltage drop across the capacitor will be lagging the current by 90 degrees, or this I can write VC is equal to IR into XC. So we know at resonance condition, these two are equal. These two will cancel each other. So your net IR into R, this will be equal to your supply voltage. This is at resonance condition. I hope everyone agree with me. So at resonance condition, we know that VL is equal to VC. Why? Both XL is equal to XC and same current is passing. So automatically your supply voltage will be equal to your VR. Why? Since Z is equal to R, because XL is equal to XC. I hope this is clear. Now, as the current is very high, automatically the voltage drop across the resistor will become equal to your supply voltage. And as the current is high, automatically IR into XL also will be high, as well as IR into XC will be very high. That means the voltage drop across inductor and capacitor will be so many times greater than your supply voltage. But as both are 180 degrees opposite to each other, if you take the net voltage across these two, automatically it will become equal to zero. So this is what we observe from here. So whereas across the resistance, it will be equal to your supply voltage. So let us proceed further. So then we can observe from here that if you are trying to draw how the current is going to change, that current will change like this. As the frequency is increasing, we know the impedance is decreasing. So as the impedance is decreasing, automatically the current will go on increasing. Let us assume this is my resonant frequency, because I know current is equal to V by Z. So Z will go on decreasing until we reach your resonant frequency. And after resonant frequency, it will go on increasing. So this is my value of the curve. So everyone agree with me? So now we know at resonance condition, the current at resonance is equal to V by Z. Z becomes R at resonance. So if the resistance is increased, automatically the current at resonance will decrease. So otherwise we can tell that for small values of R, if this is the curve, as the value of the R is increasing, the curve will go on decreasing. This is for some larger values of R. This is for larger values of arc. So now this series resonance circuit is also called as the acceptor circuit. Acceptor circuit, that it is accepting. What it is accepting? You can see here at resonance condition, the current is maximum. That means the corresponding to a particular frequency, the current will be maximum, or it is accepting that particular frequency. And it is rejecting the, virtually rejecting the remaining frequencies. Or if you can limit what is the percentage of the maximum current that should be allowed, or how much power is allowed, accordingly we can decide our bandwidth, how much width or how much band of the frequencies we want to accept. So where this circuit is used, where this acceptor circuit is used, this circuit is used in the radio and television receivers. Radio and television receivers. So let us now proceed further. So let us take the Q factor of the series resonance circuit. Q factor of series resonance circuit. So at series resonance circuits, we will observe that as we know the current is more, automatically the voltage across L or C will be so many times greater than your applied voltage. And we are going to prove that that voltage will be equal to Q factor times your applied voltage. So what is the Q factor? The Q factor stands for the quality of your series resonance circuit. The Q stands for quality. So the Q factor tells what is the quality of series resonant circuit. So the series resonant circuit can be used for voltage amplification purpose also, because the voltage drop across the inductor or the capacitor, so VL is equal to VC, will be equal to so many times greater than, far greater than your supply voltage, or we can tell that it is some Q times your supply voltage. So that we are going to see. Or we can tell the Q factor of the coil, or Q factor of the series resonance circuit, I can tell it is the voltage across the L or C divided by applied voltage. So this will become IR into XL divided by IR into R, because voltage drop across XL is IR into XL. So this I can write as XL divided by R, or this I can write as XL is nothing but omega R, the frequency corresponding to resonance, omega R into L divided by R, because we have to take at the resonance condition. We know the value of FR is equal to 1 by 2 pi root LC. This we have already derived, the resonant frequency. So from this I can tell that the value of 2 pi FR will be equal to 1 by root LC. What is 2 pi FR? 2 pi FR is nothing but your equal to omega R. So this I am substituting here. So if you substitute here, you will get the value of your Q factor. This Q factor will be equal to 1 by R into square root of L by C. This is what we get. So we got the Q factor is equal to 1 by R into square root of L by C. So let us proceed further. Let us calculate the bandwidth of series resonance circuit. bandwidth of series resonance circuit. So series resonance circuit, we know the circuit behavior will be like this. So at this point there is my resonant frequency. So at this corresponding to this point, the current is maximum. The current maximum current we know is equal to resonant current is nothing but V by R. So we have to keep the cutoff, which band of frequencies we have to allow. It is decided that it should be at 0.707 times of IR. And the frequency corresponding to these things, if you extend, this lower side which comes first, that means the lower frequency above which we allow, that is called as lower cutoff frequency, and the upper side is called as the upper cutoff frequency. So this is with respect to the frequency. So we can tell that the bandwidth of a series resonance circuit is the band of the frequencies in which your current is greater than or equal to 70.7 times of the current at the resonance condition. So where this value of F1 is called as the lower cutoff frequency, and the value of F2 is called as the upper cutoff frequency. Upper cutoff frequency. So if you want to calculate the bandwidth, the width between the band of the frequencies which is allowing, so I can define the bandwidth is equal to the change of frequency. This is nothing but equal to F2 minus F1. So let us try to calculate what will be the power at these frequencies. So at F1 and F2, I can calculate my power P is equal to, the current is equal to I corresponding to resonance divided by root 2, that is nothing but 0.707 square times of R. So this you will get as P maximum by 2. That means at upper and lower cutoff frequencies, the power of your circuit will be only 50%. That means we are keeping the threshold up to 50% of the power. So then let us try to calculate in dB, because in electronic circuits we always deal with dBs. So in dB, I can calculate my change in power level. Change in power level will be equal to 10 log to the base 10. We know at resonant frequency it is equal to P maximum. And when you are taking at the lower or upper cutoff frequency, it is becoming equal to P maximum by 2. Or this will become equal to 10 log to the base 10 of 10 log to the base 10 of, how much will come here? 2 will come. So otherwise this will come as minus 3 dB. So you will get the doubt, why I am just dividing? I have to take the difference of the power in decibels. That means actually what I am doing, I am taking 10 log to the base 10 of the maximum power minus 10 log to the base 10 of, what is the power at half power frequency? So log of A minus log A minus log B, I can write as log of A by B. So using the this scheme. So again from this we have observed that F1 and F2 in decibels we can write it as 3 decibels. So the values of F1 and F2 are also called as half power frequencies or 3 dB frequencies. Because at this point in decibels it is 3 dB less than what is the value at the maximum value, or the difference is equal to 3 decibels. Let us try to now derive the expression for half power frequency. Expression for half power frequencies. We know the current I is equal to voltage divided by the impedance, which is nothing but R square plus XL minus XC whole square. So this I can write as V divided by that R I am taking out. So this becomes 1 plus XL minus XC divided by R whole square. So this we know the ratio of V by R, because at resonance condition the impedance is equal to R. So I can write this as the current corresponding to resonance, or the nothing but the maximum current divided by 1 plus XL minus XC divided by R whole square. Because we know the ratio of V by R is nothing but it is a maximum possible current that can pass. So we know at half power frequency, at half power frequencies, the value of the current I is equal to I maximum by root 2. So I can write this I is equal to I maximum by root 2 at half power frequency. This will become equal to I maximum divided by 1 plus XL minus XC divided by R whole square. So remember here that frequency you have to substitute either F1 or F2. That is the meaning of half power frequency. Or we know the numerator is same. The denominator also should be same. That means whatever is inside the square root should be equal to 2, because 1 is already there. So from this I can tell this XL minus XC divided by R should be equal to 1, or we can tell this XL minus XC is equal to R. So let us take this as equation number 1. This is what we got. But we know that at resonant frequency, the impedance is equal to resistance, or nothing but we can tell that XL minus XC is equal to 0. That means we can tell that as the frequency changed from FR to F2, the difference of XL minus XC has reached R, because we know XL will increase with frequency and XC decreases with frequency. So I can take it that this value of XR is increased by R by 2 and the value of XC is decreased by R by 2. Because XC goes on decreasing as you are increasing the frequency. So I can write that this 2 pi F2 into L, that means this is the value of XL at the upper cutoff frequency minus the value of this impedance at the resonant frequency should be equal to R by 2. Or from this I can write my value of F2 minus FR is equal to R divided by 4 pi L. Or this I can write as F2 is equal to FR plus R divided by 4 pi L. This is the value of F2 I got. So similar way, we can tell that as you are moving from the resonant frequency to your lower cutoff frequency, as you are going towards the lower cutoff frequency, the value of XL will decrease by R by 2 and the value of XC will increase by R by 2. So that again the same difference, that R will come, that XL minus XC will become equal to R. One is decreased, another one is increased, so they will come, difference will become 2 times. So this I can write as 2 pi FR into L minus 2 pi F1 into L will be equal to R by 2, or from this I can write FR minus F1 is equal to R by 4 pi L, or from this I can write the value of the lower cutoff frequency is equal to FR minus R divided by 4 pi L. So we got the lower cutoff frequency, upper cutoff frequency. So using this I can calculate my bandwidth. So how can I calculate my bandwidth? So I can calculate my bandwidth is nothing but F2 minus F1. So this will be nothing but, you can substitute the values from here. So this becomes R divided by 2 pi L. This is my bandwidth. So bandwidth I can calculate by R divided by 2 pi into L. That will be my bandwidth. So if you know the value of the ratio of R by L, so automatically I can calculate my bandwidth easily. So you can see here the bandwidth is coming independent of the value of the capacitance. So now the further what I am doing, I am just multiplying by numerator and denominator with resonant frequency. So this I am also dividing with 2 pi FL into R. So this I can write FR into R divided by, we know that 2 pi FR into L is nothing but the value of XL at resonance conditions. So this is nothing but XL divided by R. So XL divided by R is, or omega RL divided by R is nothing but your quality factor. We have already defined your quality factor. So this will become FR divided by Q. Or from this I can write my bandwidth is nothing but the resonant frequency divided by the Q factor. Resonant frequency divided by Q factor. These are the observations we are doing. So you can see here, as the ratio of R by L, which is indicated by the quality factor Q, if the value of L is greater than R, we tell that the quality of my circuit is more. Or if the Q is increasing, you can see the bandwidth is decreasing. So bandwidth is decreasing as the Q is increasing. That means as the quality of the circuit is increasing, the bandwidth is decreasing. What is the meaning of the bandwidth? So if you draw the curve, this is my initial bandwidth. So by increasing the quality factor, your bandwidth become more narrower. The meaning, what is the meaning of the narrower? So it may reach up to maximum. So it will be much more narrower. That means it will accept very less band of frequency. That means it will select only some specific values of the frequency. That will be the advantage. Or we can tell that as the quality factor is increasing, the selectivity will increase for your circuit. That's why always I want my circuit should accept only one particular frequency. Like in the radio or the television, I want to accept only one particular frequency. But practically, because of the bandwidth, it is difficult. So I want to design my circuit in such a way that bandwidth should be as minimal as possible, so that it will accept only some small band of the frequencies. That is a property required for any circuit. So let us now see this, what is the relationship between the resonant frequency and the lower and upper cutoff frequencies? This I am not deriving because of the time constraint, so I am directly writing the answer. So the equation will be, if you know the value of f1 and f2, you can calculate the value of the fr using fr is equal to square root of f1 multiplied by f2. So let us try to take one numerical so that whatever we have discussed will be completely clarified. So I am taking one example. So it is given that a series RLC circuit has R is equal to 5 ohms, L is equal to 0.2 Henry and C is equal to 50 microfarads. The applied voltage is 200 volts. Find the first one they asked resonant frequency and second one the Q factor. Third one is bandwidth, fourth one is upper and lower cutoff frequencies, then fifth one is what is the current at resonance, then it is also asked what is the current at half power points, and the last one they have asked voltage across inductor at resonance, voltage across inductor at resonance. So the solution for this, let us see. So it is given that whatever data is given, I am just keeping it here so that analysis will be easy. It is given there the voltage is 200 volts, the value of R is given 5, L is given as 0.2 Henry and C is given as 50 microfarads. So now I can calculate one by one easily. The resonant frequency is equal to 1 by 2 pi into square root of LC. You can substitute the value of L and C, you will get this value as 50.33 Hz. So similarly, the Q factor is nothing but 2 pi FR into L divided by R. So this will be equal to 12.65. This will be the answer if you calculate this. So similar way, I can calculate my value of the bandwidth. Bandwidth is nothing but FR divided by Q, the resonant frequency divided by Q, we have derived that. So this becomes 3.98 Hz. That will be my bandwidth. So similarly, I can calculate my value of the F2 will be equal to FR plus bandwidth divided by 2. So this will become equal to 52.32 Hz. So similarly, I can calculate my F1. F1 is nothing but FR minus bandwidth divided by 2. So this comes as 48.34 Hz. So now I can calculate my value of the current at resonance. Current at resonance will be only because of the resistance, so we will get it as 40 amperes. So next one it is asked, what is the current at half power points? So the current at half power points will be equal to 0.707 times of IR, that we know this will be equal to 28.28 amperes. So the last one it is asked, what is the value of VL at resonance condition, which will be equal to IR into XL. So this IR, I can write whatever is the value of IR. IR we got as 40 multiplied by 2 pi into frequency corresponding to resonance, we got as 50.33 into the value of L is 0.2 Henry. If you substitute this, you will get 2529.87 volts. So let us try to derive it in terms of Q factor, how can I define this? So we know the value of IR is nothing but V by value of R, XL is 2 pi FR into L. So we know the ratio of 2 pi FR into L divided by R, we have defined as the quality factor. So I can write this as V multiplied by the quality factor. So using this also I can calculate. So we know the quality factor of our circuit, we got as 12.65. multiplied by your supply voltage is 200. If you multiply it, you will get the same thing, you will get it as 2530 volts. It is same, because this difference came because of the calculation mistakes we do in the calculator, because we always round off. You got it? Using this also you can calculate. I hope everything is clear to you. If you still have any queries, you can leave your comments in the comment section below. I will answer to your queries from there. So thank you very much.